Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in North Carolina. I got a few different videos to make by the grace of God. And the first one is I was just praying and the Lord gave me a word. So I wanted to share it with you. And the Lord said to me, he said, because I was asking the Lord to pour out his glory, send down the revival, pour out his glory. And the Lord said to me, he said, drink freely and be satisfied. So, the Lord gave me a text from Psalm 36. I want to read this to you. Thy mercy, O Lord, verse 5, 36, 5, Psalm. Thy mercy, O Lord, is in the heavens, and thy faithfulness reaches unto the clouds. Thy righteousness is like the great mountains, thy judgments as a great deep. O Lord, thou preservest man and beast. How excellent is thy loving kindness, O God. Therefore the children of men put their trust under the shadow of thy wings. Reminds me of Psalm 91. He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Verse 8. This is the main verse that the Lord gave me. They shall be abundantly satisfied with the fatness of thy house, and thou shalt make them drink of the river of thy pleasures. For with thee is the fountain of life. In thy light shall we see light. O continue thy loving kindness unto them that know thee, and thy righteousness to the upright in heart. Let not the foot of pride come against me, and let not the hand of the wicked remove me. There are the workers of iniquity fallen. They are cast down and should not be able to rise. Brothers and sisters, David is praying unto the Lord, a psalm of David, and he's asking the Lord, you know, to bless him and saying that those who worship the Lord and those who trust in the Lord, who put their trust in God, they shall be abundantly satisfied with the fatness of his house, of heaven. And thou shalt make them, and God, David is talking to God, and thou shalt make them fat of the river, that thou shalt make them satisfied with the fatness of your house, and you will make them drink of the river of thy pleasures. For with you, God, and with thee is the fountain of life, and in thy light we shall see light. You know, that reminds me of Revelation. At the end of Revelation, it says, you know, let them come and drink freely. Whosoever, let them come drink freely from the living water of life that flows from the throne of God, that you may drink freely. Let him come drink freely. You know, people, you know, I always hear people when they talk about the grace of God, you know, they'll say it's a free gift. I mean, if it's not free, then it's not a gift. If someone gives you a gift, it's automatically free, right? I mean, if it's not free, it's not a gift. You know, it's like these sales gimmicks, you know, where they'll say, we want to give you a free vacation, but first, you know, you need to make a deposit. Or first, you know, you need to listen to this seminar. Well, it's not really free. Something free is a gift, and something, you know, all gifts are free. If it's really a gift, brothers and sisters, it's really got to be free. And God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whomsoever shall believe in Jesus shall not perish but have everlasting life. Brothers and sisters, those who put their trust in the Lord, you know, and the Lord was just inviting me, come and drink freely and be, you know, and be satisfied. Come and freely drink, you know, and be satisfied. Can you imagine, you know, especially, brothers and sisters, as I'm preparing to go to Seattle, and all the places I've been, but particularly Seattle is probably the most place, you know, that I've been where I experienced being around wealthy people, even though there's wealthy people in lots of other places. You know, it's just coming to my mind today. This afternoon, the name of this song came to my mind. I Can't Get No Satisfaction by the Rolling Stones. You know, that's from like about 1965. I think I even mentioned that in the book that the Lord gave me to write, Final Boarding Call. Can get it on Amazon.com. Brothers and sisters, I mentioned that in there, and I talked about how that this, when the song was released, if it, Mick Jagger said if he had released it any sooner, it wouldn't have been accepted because it was kind of a suggestive song. But that kind of satisfaction, he was talking about satisfaction in the flesh, satisfaction in lust. And people run to and fro, brothers and sisters. And I guess I should stop saying brothers and sisters because by the grace of God, somebody who's watching this is not a brother or sister. Because when I say brother and sister, I mean people who are born again Christians are my brothers and sisters in Christ. We have the same Heavenly Father. You know, let me just keep going. I was going to say this. I better say it. Because the Lord is leading me to say, you know, there's lots of people that say, we're all children of God. Oh, we're all children of God. God is everybody's father. No, that's not what the Bible says. We're all God's creation. We are created by God. That doesn't make him our father. If I went out and took a piece of clay and formed it into the shape of that looked like me, would that be my child? No, it's a creation I made. But when God breathed the breath of life into Adam, then God became his son. In Luke, in the genealogy of Jesus, it goes backwards from Jesus going backwards, and it ends up with Adam, who is the son of God. You know, each one it says, you know, Jacob, who's the son of Isaac? Isaac, who's the son of Abraham? Then it goes on to say, and Adam, who was the son of God. Adam was the son of God. God breathed into that red earth man. That's what the name Adam means, is red earth man. He was made from red earth. God created him, dirt, out of dust. You know, ashes to ashes and dust to dust. From dust you came and dust you shall return, God said. So Adam was breathed in by God, and he became a living being, and he was a son of God. But after the fall, we became enemies and strangers of God and alienated from God. We have enmity with God because of our sin, brothers and sisters, our friends, and whoever is watching this video. But by the blood of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Most High God, we've been made to draw nigh or near to God, where we can become his child, as the Bible tells us in John chapter 1, to as many who believe on his name. To them, to those people, Jesus gave the power to become the sons and daughters of God. Those, just like it says right here in Psalm 36, verse 7, it says, how excellent is thy loving kindness, O God. Therefore the children of men put their trust under the shadow of thy wings. So when we put our trust in God, the people who do that, they shall be abundantly satisfied with the fatness of God. Or the, you know, the blessings of God's house of heaven, and thou shalt make them drink of the river of thy pleasure. Brothers and sisters, in this world, especially people that's got money, they should know, you know, just like King Solomon said when he wrote Ecclesiastes, he said, there's nothing new under the sun. I've been everywhere, I've done everything, and there's no meaning and there's no satisfaction in this life. At the end of Ecclesiastes, he makes the statement that our, you know, the whole meaning of man is to know God and to worship him and obey him. And that's where the satisfaction is, brothers and sisters. You will never, you can drink all the water you want. As another verse is coming to my mind, as Jesus said in John chapter 4 when he talked to the woman at the well, the Samaritan woman to the well. He said, if you knew who you were talking to, I could give you a water, because he asked her for a drink of water. She was getting water out of the well. And she said, well, you know, you're a Jew and you're asking me, I'm a Samaritan, you're asking me for water. And then he said, if you knew who was asking you for water, you would ask of me and I would give you water to drink. That's such a kind. If you drink it, you will never thirst again. And she said, give me that water, you know. And so Jesus said that the water he gives is a living water. You know, it's the living water of God, brothers and sisters. Now, that water is symbolic of the Spirit of God, just like when he breathed in Adam. You know, the Bible talks about the Holy Spirit also as the Ruach Elohim in the Hebrew, the breath of God, the wind of God is compared to the wind. The Lord Jesus Christ in John chapter 3 also compared the Holy Spirit to a wind. You can see the effect, but you don't know where it's going and you don't know where it came from. But the Holy Spirit is also the rushing, mighty river of God flowing from under the throne of God, the Bible tells us, the river of living water. As Jesus said in John chapter 7, out of your belly would flow rivers of living water. That's the Holy Spirit, brothers and sisters. As the Lord told us, he would give us another comforter. That is what satisfies us. It's what satisfies us. It's the indwelling of the presence of the creator of the universe. And as a Christian, it is our Father, not the earthly fathers can't satisfy us. There's been a lot of bad dads, but you know what? There's been lots of human dads who have been great. Lots of human dads have been great. And the FYI, as it's just coming to my mind, Jesus said in Matthew, he said, call no man father because you have one Father in heaven. Any religion who tells you to call your spiritual advisor a father is in direct contradiction of the very words of the Lord Jesus Christ, who said, call no man father, because you have one Father, even your Father who is in heaven. So we, brothers and sisters, if you are a born-again Christian, the creator of the universe is also our Father. You know, as John said in his first letter that he wrote, he said, you know, what manner of love is this? That we should be called the sons of God. Can you imagine that the great Yahweh Elohim, the God of who created heaven and earth, the Lord himself, you know, Jehovah, Yahweh, who would call us his children? You know, thanks be to God, he causes us to triumph in all things in Christ Jesus. For his is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Blessed be his holy name. Brothers and sisters, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. If you do not know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, I advise you, I beseech thee that you call upon the name of the Lord right now. For the Bible says, all who call upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ shall be saved.